By now, I've done a couple of videos on things related to Mia, the history of the project, and things like that, and at some point, I think I'm gonna have to actually go and use it. Now, the reason I'm saying Mia is I finally worked out how to actually say it, because at Ubuntu Summit 2024, there was a talk on Miriway, Worlds of Wayland, hosted by Alan Griffiths, the lead of the Mia project, and Neil Gomper, who, if you've seen a lot of my prior videos, you probably already know who he is and doesn't really need an introduction. Now, a few years back, Alan had a very simple thought, one that you might have had in the past as well.
One day, a couple of years ago, I was thinking, well, why don't we have Mia on the desktop? So I sat...
Why not? Well, there are many reasons for that. A lot of people were not happy about Mia because they were just trash-talking Wayland the entire time, and there was the whole, like, Unity and Convergence thing, which ended up being dropped, and then Mia became a Wayland library, and then it's been relegated to the embedded space. Now, Alan wants to rectify this problem and wants to make it something that people actually use on the desktop, so we went ahead and made Miriway. Now, to be clear, Miriway isn't a new project and has been around for a couple of years now. You can go and download it from GitHub. A lot of distros have packages for it already, and you can just go and use it. Now, if you're a long-time viewer, you probably have a relatively decent understanding of what Wayland is, how things fit together, the fact that all of these things that we talk about in Wayland are all based around Wayland protocols, but also the fact that building a Wayland compositor is kind of a pretty big undertaking. And we've talked about the problem of these smaller desktop environments that might not exactly have the time and energy to go and focus on that problem. They just have the time to work on the desktop tooling. So if they want to go and move over to Wayland, it's kind of a challenge. Whilst we do have compositors like Kwin and Mutter, which is the compositor component of Plasma and GNOME respectively, these are made for those specific environments. They're not intended to be used in another environment. You could go and do so, but you can't really expect that changes won't be made that break everything you do. So you probably want to go and build your own compositor based on a compositor library like Smithy, WRoots, or Mir itself. The problem is building a compositor off a compositor library isn't as difficult as doing it from scratch, but even so, it still requires quite a bit of knowledge to get something that is actually fairly usable. And there are functional compositors that already exist, like Hyprland, Sway, River, Hikari, but a lot of the compositors that already exist, with the exception of things like Hikari and a few other projects, are not floating, right? Like, they are tiling compositors because that's what sort of existed in the X11 space. If you're using a standalone window manager, for the most part, they were tiling because that's what people in that space had wanted and that's what developers in that space build. But even so, whilst there are these floating solutions, they're not intended to be used as the core of a desktop environment. They're intended to be used as standalone floating compositors. So if you're one of these desktops that just doesn't really have the resources, like an LXQt, an XFCE, and things like that, how do you move over to Wayland? And that is the goal that Miriway is trying to solve, because LXQt did recently announce their Wayland session, and they are using these existing compositors, but what if you had something built specifically for being used as a generic compositor? And this is exactly what Miriway is aiming to be, allowing these developers to focus on the part of their project that they actually want to work on, the applications in their desktop environment. To do this, Miriway is providing all of the sensible things you would expect. Things like floating window management, configurable docs, configurable key bindings, support for on-screen keyboards, WayVNC, hybrid graphics support, and the project itself is actually quite short. Right now it's only got a couple hundred commits, but the actual size of the code base is only about 1300 lines of code, So if you want to go and take the project and then fork it into something different, that can also be done with relative ease. Also, with this not being a canonical project, yes, it is made by a canonical employee, and yes, he is employed to work on Mia as a canonical employee, but Miriway is its own separate thing. It is not affected by the canonical CLA. It is just a straight GPL V3 project, and that is all. Now, Neil isn't just here to look pretty, and Neil isn't just here because he likes Mia and Miriway and Alan wants some company on stage. There's also some stuff happening over in Fedora land. There's a bunch of Mia-related packages currently circulating in Fedora Rawhide that's allowing some fun things to be done. And of course, Neil wanted to be funny on stage and do the thing you should never ever do when you're on stage. You can already see what's about to happen.
So, let's talk about practically using Miriway. So, demonstration slide, right? Well, you know, what if it was here the whole time?
That's it, live demos.
Yeah, that's the live demo part. But we already figured that part out. And that is, if I replug and unplug, you can see that we have
a
LXQt desktop environment.
Look at that, it's LXQt and Miriway. Again, this is why you don't do live demos. It's gonna break. Now, is this one done on purpose because, haha, get a couple of laughs from the crowd? I wouldn't put it past him. And if you recall not too long ago, I did a video about LXQt introducing exactly this. Preview LXQt release 2.1, where they introduced their Wayland session, but they didn't introduce a Wayland compositor because they don't have the time, the knowledge, the energy, whatever reason for it, to go and build their own compositor. They are relying on compositors that already exist. Things like Hyprland, LabWC, Kwin, Niri, Sway, River, Wayfire, and in this case, Neil is showing off Miriway. There is a reason why they didn't do Miriway or anything Mia-based in their thing here in the LXQt update, because whilst this is cool and Miriway is a cool project, Mira is still missing a lot of stuff to make it even remotely functional as a daily driver. The biggest missing thing is portals. There's no Mia portal currently, so you can't do things like screen capture. Flatpaks are literally unusable without like completely breaking the sandbox apart. A lot of other basic things that you expect to be on other desktops do not yet function because the portal does not yet exist. This is on the roadmap. It is very important, and it's about 6 months away-ish, at least for some of the early versions of the portal, when it gets to a point where it's as comprehensive as something like KDE or GNOME's portal. Only time will tell. It'll eventually get to that point, but this is not like a fundamental problem. It's just Mia on the desktop was kind of ignored for quite a while, so it's taken a bit to sort of bring it up to snuff. Now, as mentioned before, these packages exist over in Fedora Rawhide, and this test was being done on Fedora LXQt. Now, this isn't just some like little secret test or something made for the sake of the talk, right? This is something that is actually being worked on as something that is going to be available to Fedora users. Right now, there is currently an ISO available to test this, right? Keep in mind, early, possibly gonna break, not really expected for production code that you shouldn't rely on. This is supposed to be more available in the LXQt spin by Fedora 42. Hopefully by then things like portals are ironed out and things are in a better state, and you actually will want to go, maybe not will, but you could reasonably go and use it as a daily driver system. Now, like any sensible solution, and I don't know if this is going up before or after the Cosmic Ubuntu Summit video, but like in that one as well, making use of these common upstream Wayland protocols, these common Wayland extensions, to make it easy to use Miriway in basically any normal configuration you want to go and use. For example, things like XDG decoration for server-side decorations, input method V1 alongside the newer versions of the protocol, because the whole thing with Wayland and input methods and on-screen keyboards and all this stuff is just, it's just a mess and just a disaster. I've done a video on that. It's a problem that'll never be resolved. And again, the goal is not to curate the experience to something that is perfect for Miriway. It is to provide the tools to make it easy to go and build something off of that system. As such, there's more additional changes being made to just make it make more sense for these solutions, to make it a good generic solution, along with just generally making it a better environment to work with. Along with improvements to side-by-side installations, because a lot of people do make use of more than one desktop environment. So if you had something like LXQt, and then one of the things Neil wants to work on is using Miriway as the compositor inside of XFCE, giving that a Wayland environment. They are working on their own like WLroots thing, but this is another approach that could be done. So you will have two different systems using the same Miriway binary and improving the systems to make it so you can do these side-by-side installations and have it configured easily in different ways for these two different environments that don't end up conflicting with each other. Now, LXQt and XFCE are just two relatively, not big, but like big in the space of the random desktops that exist on the Fedora repos. There's just tons of little ones that many of you probably heard of, but a lot of them just kind of exist out there, but not many people actually use them. And Neil's been going around to some of these environments, asking the developers like what their goal is for Wayland, because like it or not, the goal very shortly in the near future, maybe a couple of years from now, is to fully drop Xorg from Fedora, to fully drop it from a lot of other distros. On places like Arch, it'll probably be relegated to things like the AUR. This is the direction we're going, and it's gonna happen sooner than a lot of people expect. And it's important to deal with these problems now, rather than deal with them when we're like, you know, 6 months away from Xorg being removed. This idea of having this generic compositor, not to the same extent of something like Xorg, which does just tons of things that nobody really needs from a system nowadays, like the fact that you could print your screen to a printer, like you could use a printer as an output device. This made sense at a point, but nowadays, for most people, is just redundant functionality, and I think is effectively being removed from Xorg anyway. It's just a fun example I like to bring up of just random things that exist in Xorg that most people never interact with. But a lot of people have wanted some generic solution, and whilst the compositors that exist out there are already fairly good, they're not designed to be that solution. I'm curious to see if this idea is going to be adopted as Mia gets better, as portals for it become available, and it becomes like something you might actually want to use. Maybe it just goes nowhere, right? Maybe this is just an experiment that Alan has, and it's just a thing that maybe like one project uses, and it's kind of like a small project. Or maybe this becomes the way that a lot of projects which weren't really going to be able to move over to Wayland find a way to do so. But let me know what you think. Do you think this is a cool idea? Do you think this is just like a giant waste of effort? Were you even aware that Mia was still around and was now Wayland? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, and LiberaPay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and it's a miracle. That's also another project.